I love a good pair of coveralls, especially if they fit well. The benefit of making them myself, of course, is that I can make them however I want. In this case, I made the coveralls that Kaylee wears in Firefly. In the process, I tried out two new things, an overlock stitch and a twin needle. I traced the pattern from a basic pair of coveralls that I already own, like I've shown you in other videos. Then I made some alterations to make them match Kaylee's, like the waistband, the pocket placement, and the zipper. With the pattern ready, I pinned the pieces onto the fabric and cut them out. Cotton twill frays quite a bit, so I wanted to take care of the edges properly. I got very excited when I discovered that my machine can actually do an overlock stitch. This normally requires a special sewing machine, but apparently a regular machine can achieve a similar effect, as long as you have the right presser foot. It sews a zigzag stitch over the edge of the fabric, locking the fibers in place. The special presser foot has a little bar that holds onto the stitches while you sew, and that means the thread tension doesn't make the fabric bunch up. It's not as fast or flexible as a special overlock machine or serger, but it gets the job done and it looks so much better than a regular zigzag stitch. So as preparation, I overlocked the edges of all the pieces. Onto the assembly. Based on Kaylee's coveralls, I added two small pleats by the front waistband. I also added the neck facing on the upper back. Then I got to work on the pockets. I folded the top edge of the pieces inwards and sewed them down. Then I folded the other edges inwards as well and pinned them onto the front coverall pieces. Now I could sew them in place. I got to experiment with another new trick here, the twin needle. This double needle allows me to sew two perfectly parallel lines at once, which is a detail that you'll find on a lot of clothing. It requires two threads from the top instead of one, so I wound an extra bobbin with thread to use it as a makeshift spool. The main thing to remember here is that the parallel lines of stitching only show on the top, not on the bottom, so you have to take that into account when you sew your pieces. I also used this opportunity to sew on Kaylee's signature bear patch. The next step was to set in the zipper. I placed it right sides together on the front piece, and then placed the facing on top of it, right side down, and used clips to keep it all in place. I used a zipper foot to sew close to the zipper teeth and making sure to keep an even distance. I repeated this on the other side. Then I folded the facing to the inside, exposing the zipper. A line of top stitching keeps everything nice and flat. I folded the raw edge of the facing over and pinned it to the front piece. Now I can sew this down with a top stitch as well. Next up were the back leg pieces. I also closed the crotch seam. Now I added the upper back piece. Again, clipping it in place, sewing it down. Then I closed the shoulder seams. And finally, I could close the side seams, all the way from the armholes down to the bottom of the legs. The last piece to add was the collar. I first pinned and sewed it onto the outside of the neck, and then I folded it over, tucked in the raw edges, and sewed it onto the outside as well. I added a line of top stitching all the way around to close the sides and keep it flat. To finish it up, I sewed the hem on the pant legs and armholes. I did this by folding the edges inwards twice and sewing it in place. I also added a piece of elastic to the back around the waist, and I stretched the elastic out as I sewed. This makes the fabric bunch up around it and it gives a really nice fit. Finally, I added the waistband itself, which is only attached above the two front pockets. Of course, I added my label. And now the coveralls are pretty much done. But I wasn't done yet. I wanted to add a few more details to make these really look like Kaylee's coveralls. First up were two extra patches, a heart and a flower. I cut the heart from some red felt. The flower took a bit more effort since it's crocheted, but it's nothing too crazy. It did end up way too big though, so I made a second one with thinner yarn and a smaller crochet hook. I used a fabric marker to add the dark blue outline and some yellow yarn for the center. I stitched both patches onto the coveralls by hand with a simple whip stitch. The final touch was to add the Chinese writing. I marked the rough location and size with chalk and used a fabric marker to draw the characters. Now they're really done. I love the fit. They are definitely more stylish than regular coveralls, but just as functional. And I love how some simple alterations like pocket placement and patches took these from normal coveralls to Kaylee's coveralls. I will definitely be making more of these in lots of styles. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.